yourself. Who are you?
Well, my name is Una Djordjevic. I'm coming from Serbia, born and raised in Serbia, 32 years old.
Okay, and where are you now?
Right now I'm living in Norway, married and living in Norway for the last almost 2 years.
To my friend Ule, I believe?
Yes.
Wait, not right.
I started, I've been into training my whole life.
Yeah.
So when I was 13, 14, I started first aerobic and then I trained for a while karate. And when I was 21, I started going to the gym, but it was nothing serious. It was just three times, didn't have a clue what I was doing at the gym. So when I was 25, I started preparing for my first competition, which was figure division.
Okay, no problem. So what made you change from going to the gym generally to being like, okay, I'm going to take this serious?
There were many people that suggested me that I should try competing because that I had like athletic figure. Mm-hmm. And that was in back of my mind for a while. And then one day I just decided to try.
Okay, no problem. So do you remember who your first serious training partner was?
There were a couple of mentors that I had, but I like to train, and still I like to train by myself because I like to be completely focused, not talk during sets, preserve my energy, have like my earphones, and that's how I work the best.
Okay, so you have no problems pushing yourself and getting through each set and reps. That's cool, no problem. So did you have anybody that you used to like look up to at the time, someone that you were like, oh, look at them?
There were many women which figure I liked, but the first I can say that it was like Latoria Watts. She was Miss Figure Olympia, and her physique was something that I liked the most, and so I can say that she was the first idol.
Perfect, perfect. So what kind of training methods do you follow?
Before, when I was competing in figure division, I did bit more of volume during my workouts, and it was like different training split. I had also much more upper body, lower body. It was 5 to 6 times a week sessions, and then only one day rest day or maximum 2 rest days.
Okay. Yeah.
But now I'm training 2 days, and every 3rd day is day off.
Okay.
I'm doing like more short but intense workouts. The majority is just leg and glute focused, and I follow cluster sets, SST sets, and just like keeping it short and intense.
Yeah, that is intense for sure. Okay, no problem. So you said it's mostly glutes and legs focused?
Yes.
Is there a reason why you don't train your upper body so much?
Yes, because when I did like my last figure competition, I decided not to compete in figure anymore, so I tried to switch to wellness.
Okay.
And for that division, it's less upper body mass required.
Right. Yeah.
So first I tried training like less frequent, but I still maintained the size in my upper body, so I had to stop completely training my upper body.
Yeah.
And then of course I have to train back because I have to support compound exercises with back muscles, of course, and prevent injuries. So I can say that back workout is the only upper body that I do now.
Okay, all right, okay. And you feel that's enough?
Yes.
Yeah, no problem. So which training day do you look forward to the most?
Quads, because I have free squats then, and it's a love-hate relationship.
Yeah, fair enough. No problem. So, you said you started competing, did you say 2015-16?
2015, I started my prep, first prep, and first competition was 2017.
Yeah, okay, no problem. And how did that go?
Did very well. I did first competition, so it was San Marino 2017, Olympia amateur, and I competed in figure division, and I won my first competition, won a pro card, so it was really well.
Fantastic, nice. Okay, no problem. So when you're getting ready for a competition, can you explain how your mindset is when you're going through this preparation?
Well, my mindset is pretty much the same, like off-season, on-season. When it comes to strength training, I just try to do max to give my 100% every workout. And that thing, that strength training is something that stays same off-season and on-season. The difference on-season is I'm more dedicated to diet and definitely cardio.
Yeah,
so Yes. Yeah. It's the biggest change. So strength training is pretty much the same always.
Yeah. Okay. No problem.
It's a motivation because I have a date that I have to be lean at that date, so I have to stick to the diet 100%.
For sure. Yeah. So it's more intense now. Yeah. Fair enough. So you've gone through all the preparation. You're there backstage now. You're maybe hours, minutes, ready to get on stage. What's going through your mind at that time?
Nothing. I'm thinking more about the stage, months, weeks, days before competition. But when it's a competition day, I just try to do my best and try not to embarrass myself.
No problem. So the first thing you do after the competition?
Eat.
Eat. Anything in particular?
Anything.
Food.
Yes.
So do you have like a favorite during your prep? Do you have like a favorite food that you eat during your prep?
Before I had cheat meals every 6 days, 7 days, but recently I stopped completely with cheat meals, so my diet is 100% clean now. I'd say like at least 90% clean.
Okay.
So recently I eliminate all the processed food, all additional or in sugar in general, and I think I'm responding better to that because that way I can keep my insulin sensitivity good all year round. Mm-hmm. And it's also proven how negative effect a lot of sugar intake has when it comes to inflammation, when it comes to recovery, when it comes to liver itself. So I think the diet should be 100% clean, no matter if you're an athlete or not.
Okay, that's good news. That's good information, sorry. So do you have a favorite cheat meal?
Well, right now I don't have tea, but let's say I can make like spaghetti with meat and let's Perfect. Add more fat Perfect. To that meal, yeah. healthy fat that yeah. I usually don't have in like normal diet.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, cool, no problem. So, talking about training, when you're in the gym, you see people, of course we all do, but is there something that you see as a common mistake that's made over and over again?
I see that they're not having any plan how to train. They just go randomly from one machine to another. So I should suggest to everyone if they're not familiar with strength training, they should have a coach who they can learn the basics and then continue with the coach or continue by themselves when they learn the basics. And talking too much.
Yeah, fair enough. No problem. So for anybody that feels like they've not made any progress in the last 6 months, year, 2 years, and they're thinking of giving up, what kind of advice would you give them?
Something needs to be changed. Either is the diet, either is the training, either is not enough recovery, but you can't expect to have the different results doing the same thing over and over again.
Fair enough, no problem. And I believe you're a personal trainer yourself?
Yes.
Okay, can you tell us more about that?
Yes, I do PT sessions and I do online coaching. Everything is customized and whether they're athletes they want to compete for or just regular people just wanting to change their lifestyle. So we first have to discuss their lifestyle, their previous diet, previous training experience, what their age, if they have any health issues or any injuries, and then when we have everything there, then according to the goals, I'll make the customized program, strength training, cardio, diet plan, and supplementation. Some people respond better to ketogenic diet, some people, like me, I respond better to the little bit higher carb diet. Okay. It's everything individual, and then we need first to discuss everything and figure out.
Okay, so if somebody wanted to contact you, how would they contact you?
They can contact me on Instagram. My Instagram is Una Djordjevic, IBB Pro, or with my email, unaazrael@gmail.com.
Fantastic, thank you very much. Una.
Thank you.
cluster sets just to get the better blood flow there, and then we're gonna move to the most likely Bulgarian, even though it's more like quad glute exercise Bulgarian split squat. I feel it nice in my hamstrings, so I usually incorporate it in my hamstrings workout, and standing leg curl, that's gonna be most likely at the end. And in the meantime, I'll see how I feel. So either we're gonna do a V squat reverse, or it's gonna be pendulum, wide stance, vertical leg press. We're gonna see during workout.